All right, first time ever coming here, going to Ag Hall for their gigantic yard sale. I've never been to this. It's been a thing for like the last, I don't know how many years. Everyone talks about it, and now we're here. So let's see what it's all about.
We take pride in our trained specialists who provide the best possible solution to protect your order. Our staff is like me. I should know. I'm just
I can't already be there. Call us today.
This person has quite the collection of stuff.
Yeah, it's Pyrex.
That was Fire King, and the person's like, yeah, it's Pyrex. yeah, I love it.
Just to find some of your own someday. I'm literally having a conversation with myself, the guy with the dummy.
Some nice stuff. They're all, like, they're wondering about prices. They're all over the board. All right, my first buy of the day. Don't find these too often. Souvenir hats. I Heart New York hats. You got the Twin Towers still on it. Really neat. Kind of sensory overload. That's kind of my first impression here. These are really cute.
I'll be right back.
I don't know if they probably made them.
Good job on that.
Yeah. Oh, those are really nice.
Yeah.
But yeah, sensory overload for sure.
I saw that sitting
on some guy's shelf. All right, music's kind of loud in here, so I won't. I'll just try to talk even louder, but this is another section. I don't know how much recording I want to be able to do because they just have loud music, but hopefully we'll find some more stuff. So far, I only got that hat. Dollar float.
360. It doesn't play as 360. Say Siri.
Danielle. Thank you, sir.
I'd like to know what sounds like. What's a green next? Thank you. That's a
good one. Oh, yeah.
No,
I'd be in trouble if he was that old.
Sagittarius.
That was a complete dot set. You guys have seen me pick up one or two bowls here and there. You want $350 for the whole set. In case you guys were wondering. I don't know if that's really a good deal or a deal that kind of, or a price you put on it that you don't really want to sell it. But I know I've found the dots in a handful of videos. One bowl here, one bowl there. Royal bags. You see everything at these places. Shelving over there was a good deal. $10 each on those. Cabinets are eh, but the shelving is really nice. Stuff over here. I like how they also make it like certain prices. Like this is all $5 stuff, this is all $10 stuff. Makes it really easy. I think if you do these once a year kind of sales or twice a year kind of sales, you kind of have to price like that or price every single individual item. So there's just way too many people coming through that are going to ask you prices. Now this is a full blown, that guy knows what he's doing, or knows what he has, or both. College for any of my local people. You probably driven by at some point. I have never driven by it, so all the time I find Muhlenberg College apparel at thrift stores, I always think, oh yeah, it's in Allentown, but I've never actually been here. So driving through it right now, this is kind of, it's nice, you know, it's probably really nice in the spring. Good old Muhlenberg College. I would never have known if they didn't have these red flags up everywhere. That's a nice house. All right, so I made it home. Not really a whole lot for salsa smell this time. I had a blast there. It was my first time ever going to this sale. I know it's been going on for quite some time, and everyone always asks me, hey, did you go up to Ag Hall? Because it's called Agricultural Hall, to my knowledge. It's at the Allentown Fairgrounds. I've never been up there. I've never been to the fair. I've never been to this place. I've never been to this yard sale. I had a feeling that everything would be really, really expensive, and it's kind of hit or miss. I actually thought prices were a little bit cheaper than what I was expecting. So you can probably find some things. It seemed like it was mostly like people who wanted to have a yard sale but didn't want to go to a flea market, or they were a flea market person, and since flea markets around here really aren't open, they decided to do this yard sale thing. So it's a mix of like the two. But you really didn't have a lot of like junky quarter stuff, 50 cents, stuff you would probably see at like a regular yard sale where the person has like everything they haven't used in the last 20 years out for sale. There wasn't really a lot of that kind of stuff. It was more like specialized, like there's clothing people that just did clothing. There were other people who just did antiques. There was other crafters that had craft stuff. So I did get a couple of things. I only got two things. So I paid $2 for this hat. There are a lot of hat people there selling and buying, which to me was kind of different, interesting, because I don't really go to vintage shows, so I don't really get to see people who have, I guess, really decent stuff selling clothes. Usually if I ever find clothes, it's like you find one or two items out of a huge pile of stuff, whereas there's other people selling and they literally had hundreds of hats that were all good for, you know, a couple bucks, but they wanted $5 or $10 a piece. This one I only paid $2 for. The person was not a hat dealer. It was just they had like 8 or 10 hats. So that was kind of cool. And then lastly, I got this one frying pan. So this is a nice frying pan. It was only $10, as you guys see. I didn't see any cracks. It's number 10. And it's a Wagner. So it is marked. It's not an unmarked pan. I thought this was a great buy for 10 bucks. I think the only reason why I was able to get it for $10 is because at this show, in any show, it's a little bit different where you have to like walk the stuff back to your car, but you have to leave like the complex. So something like this actually weighs a lot. I didn't really want to walk around with a frying pan for the whole show, but I managed to just do that because I was like, screw it. So about halfway through, I was like, you know what? I'll just buy it and walk around with it. I made my bag super, super heavy. But for $10 for a frying pan, it's in great shape. Like I said, I don't think there's any cracks on it, but nice Wagner for 10 bucks. You usually don't find marked skillets, at least not Wagner, Griswold, Erie, the main brands, the vintage or antique brands at a show for under 10 bucks or under like $20. It's usually like something, if it's marked, it's usually priced a little bit, I wouldn't say out of range, but more towards collectors. So that was fun. I had a great time. I probably will go back again for the next show. It poured here today. It's actually pouring right now. Might be able to see out there, the pond's getting absolutely drenched. There's currently like a river running through my yard. Man, raindrops hitting the bottom. So that's going to kind of wrap it up. Thanks for tagging along. I don't know when the next show is. This show might be better than ones that they have in the summer. I don't even know if they have shows in the summer. But because it is still too early for the flea markets around here, I think that's the reason why a lot of people were there. And yeah, sorry for the editing on the video. If it might have been weird, they just played really loud music, so I kind of had to edit around things. The life of a content creator on YouTube. If I was on a different platform, it wouldn't be a big issue, but YouTube just doesn't like music. So it is what it is, but it was fun. Thanks for tagging along, everyone. If you guys enjoy, hit the like button, subscribe down below for more treasure hunts. Till next time, have a great day. Keep living the dream. Peace.